Well, she is definitely a winner, Russ. We're talking about former world number one and three-time winner of this event, Victoria Azarenka, who took out Dominika Sibulkova in three sets. First ever match on this court, and you got a really good look at it for 2.5 hours. Tell us what it plays like, what it feels like, what it sounds like.
Yeah, as you said, I wanted to stay there as long as possible. You know, I loved it so much that I thought, two sets is not enough. I need full three sets. But it was really an honor for me to play. They asked me last week if I would want to play it for the first match, and I was like, yes, of course. It's amazing. I feel that the improvement has been done. You know, moving this tournament to this stadium is incredible for tennis players, for fans. It's going to continue to grow, and that's what it should be. You know, every tournament should be growing. And the court feels great. The only thing I would suggest maybe is to start matches maybe at 1 or at 11 so that shade is not right in the beginning of the match. But I think that's something, you know, it's a first year. It's something can be adjusted, hopefully. But other than that, it was beautiful. I thought the crowd was great. So I really enjoyed my time.
Well, you've been a tremendous champion here multiple times, so well-deserved for you to play that first match on the court. You admitted earlier this year after Australia to struggling a bit, trying to get back to the form you expect. You had an incredible match with Serena Williams at Indian Wells in the second round, probably the best of the year thus far. What does a match like that do for your tennis?
Well, it definitely kind of showed me that everything I've been kind of working on in practice, which I've been doing well, I couldn't really transfer that in the beginning of the match into the matches. And in that match, I really did that. Even though I came up short, it really showed me, okay, now you can, you're doing those steps forward that needed to be done. So it was a good little bit of boost of confidence in a way. Even though it's a loss, but you learn always, you know that. You learn better from losses than from wins, so it was a good match for me.
They say one of the hardest things to do in this sport is the sunshine double, to win Indian Wells in this tournament back-to-back, which you did 3 years ago, beat Serena in the Indian Wells final, and then came here, well, not here, but there, and won the tournament without dropping a set. Where do you list that on your list of career accomplishments? You have many.
Yeah, it's, you know, I don't really look back at that yet, but it's definitely something I will be cherishing after my career.
Why is it so hard to do these two back-to-back?
Because it's a full month of just focus, you know. You don't have time to rest. You're there every day, you know. Even though you have a day off, you can't really take it off. You still have to practice, and you still have to, you know, keep your focus. So to keep your whole focus for 1 month is quite challenging, and it's definitely going to be in one of my favorite moments of my career. I actually never liked the trophies, so I don't really know where my trophies are, but I will remember the victories for sure.
You didn't like the actual
trophies? I don't like trophies.
Why not?
I don't know. I don't know where any of my trophies really, honestly. I just like the win. I like to win. I like to take a picture, and the rest don't matter.
You know, we've talked about some of the improvements in your game, but you've also had to improve your packing abilities traveling with your son, Leo.
Yeah.
So tell me, what have you learned now that he's almost 2 years old?
Oh, yeah, I learned a lot. I learned to pack only one bag now instead of four, like the first trip. So, it's about, you know, he loves cars, so all he needs is cars. So we definitely can't live anywhere without cars. And the good thing, you know, a lot of pharmacies, a lot of little stores, you can buy cars, so it's better than packing and paying for overweight. So, but yeah, the lessons had to be learned for sure.
The important lessons.
Yeah.
Congratulations on learning the mommy lessons. Congratulations on a big win today, and on the honor of christening this court.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Victoria Azarenka looking for title number 4 in Miami, off and running. She'll play Caroline Garcia next. Ted Robinson steps into the booth when we come back. Day 2 coverage live from Miami continues in just a moment.